came from Jesus.
Today's word is reciprocity. Reciprocity. Don't ask me to do a damn thing that you wouldn't do for me.
I'm saying if you meet a guy today,
yes.
Let me look. Let's say you met me, like you just did.
Mm-hmm.
And how soon would you kiss me and how soon would you go back home with me?
I don't know. If I had time.
If you like him a lot and he likes you a lot. Do you feel a need to wait a day or two? Or
no,
So you go the same day?
Yes.
That's all I need to know.
Get your passport.
There you go, brothers. Passport bros. We on the ship. Getting ready to play. Room's not ready for a couple hours, but we just say, BAM! Hold the line.
To know that you need to quit trusting women so much. I have a chick in Colombia, and I have a chick in every country I've been to now. I got a chick in Colombia. We keep in touch, but we don't talk every day. I know she's messing around with other dudes, whether she wants to admit to it or not, and I also don't care.
I'm choosing signals. We sat over there and talked for maybe 2 or 3 minutes, and then I asked her for her number, and she's like, I'm not going to give you my number because it doesn't look like you have a hard time getting people's numbers. And I was like, what the fuck? What kind of stupid ass logic is that? So like I was telling them, let me go to the barber shop and be like, you know what, I'm not gonna sit in your chair because you don't look like you have a hard time getting clients. So I'm not gonna become another customer. just let me just dry ass make shit. That's what y'all deal with. And I've never heard this in Brazil, Colombia, or Thailand. So if y'all enjoy that, go make a video, go watch a dating coach video on how to respond to complete stupidity. But I'm not dealing with that shit.
Shout out. To the Brazilian men that did not allow their women to get exploited by the passport bro community. Shout out to y'all. A lot of men in America, a lot of brothers in America, they think I hate them. How can I hate something of which I come from? No, I want y'all to do better. I want the brothers in America to take the stand and not allow our sisters to get exploited. I would love to see that. Why do we let our sisters get exploited by the music industry? Why do we let our sisters get exploited by America in general? Why do we do it? Why are we complacent with these things? And then you make excuses for it. Let me tell you a secret. It doesn't even matter. See, because in Brazil, certain professions that the women were doing technically were legal. But it didn't matter that they were legal because the men felt like those women were being exploited.
I really do like this guy's TikTok videos. I didn't know him before this passport bros debacle, but I really do like his videos. Anyway, this is the much revered Stephanie Ribeiro of Brazil, the activist. Put a halt to all nefarious proceedings by the passport bros in Brazil. She posted, she said, men who complain that they can't attract women's interest in their country because they don't have money, now saying that they are going to generate a millionaire crisis in my country. Ha ha ha. You may have single-handedly cost Brazil millions of dollars in tourist money from black male Americans. I am sure the Brazil Ministry of Tourism will be pleased with that. The exodus has already begun. Congratulations. You see, when you don't really assess your opponent, you predators, not every prey is that submissive and you can just subdue them. Now, this, I did a video on passport bros. I gave my opinion in a prior video. Check out that video and my other videos as well. There's good stuff over here. Please keep coming. There's good stuff over here. Share my videos. And as usual, please like, subscribe, comment. Let's just have a conversation. Let's exchange thoughts and opinions on the topics that I speak on. Now, this passport bros situation, like I mentioned in my other video, I never paid keen attention to these guys because, I mean, these are men, obviously, who do not feel desired because they're broke and they're targeting people. women, they believe that they can conquer. Because in their minds, I mean, this is a perception of South American, Latin American countries and countries in South America, that they have this perception that we are in need and we are impoverished to a point of stupidity and desperation.
Here is where they made a grave mistake and they really did not do their homework. Because of the fact that American men are disrespectful to their women, do not protect their women, see their women as their competition, they believe that that transfers to other cultures. Hell no. And listen, these passport bros, and it is evident in how they were treated. Now the men are standing up for their women. It doesn't matter what their women's occupation is, because I mean, in every society, there's going to be that segment that's going to be deemed as not as, you know, the normal lifestyle that everyone else is you know, indulges. But those are personal choices. And, you know, the passport bros are just so, another thing is that they're just so socially awkward. I say this because now I'm paying attention to the way they operate. And it is obvious that there is a deficit in their social maneuverings. Now I've seen videos of them in Brazil somewhat interviewing potentials. And that in itself is off-putting. Who does that? I mean, it is so tacky. It clearly shows intent. And what I found is that Black American men are too self-absorbed to even take time out to do introspection to help with self-discovery and self-awareness. What they would do though is that they would blame troll, you know, they would shift blame. It's always, oh, the women are too bossy, the women are too demanding, shut up. They complain all the time because they cannot measure up. And you know, if they were operating from that conscious thinking place, they would not now be made targets. They might be cunning, but obviously they're not smart. You badmouth your women publicly. Now listen to this, we all have ears. But don't expect backlash at some point challenging your stance on why you cannot get along with your own women. Come on, passport bros. And remember, these are the guys who talk about 50-50 relationships. The Brazilian culture does not speak to 50-50 relationships. Newsflash, those men provide for their women, they're protectors, the women feel safe. And listen, when a woman feels safe and protected, she operates differently. Don't mistreat her, abandon her, badmouth her, disrespect her, and be the least dependable, the freaking least dependable, and expect that, you know, they'll act favorably towards you. Hell no. And listen, there's an obvious misconception as it relates to why these women from these cultures are the way they are, hence these foreigners' quest for this treasure. These women respond because of what has been given to them. Culturally, these women were taught to be good to their men, and it is usually because their men are there. Like I said, they're protectors and providers. It starts from your fathers, your brothers. You see this in the household. How they cater to their fathers and the men in their household, that is how they'll project and go out into the world. Notwithstanding their orientation, there's also a caveat. Now, depending on where you are in Brazil and your, you know, socioeconomic situation, most of these men are minors. So they go out there, they provide for their families, and it is expected that the women will stay at home and take care of their men when, you know, they have to. This is what the passport bros are seeking. This is what the passport bros are seeking. They need, I think these guys, because they don't understand cultural differences and so forth. These guys need to travel more. And they also have to be receptive of new information, which could lead to a healthy mindset. Because their way of thinking as it is right now is not healthy. There has to be that inflection point where change could occur. And with change, you evaluate where you are presently, and then you open yourself to that evolution. I am so amused by them. And then another thing, why would you announce your intentions? going to a foreign country. Why would you? That is less than smart. You know what? They do this intentionally because that is the pull factor. Because they know that the exchange rate, the for their currency, is they'll get more for their buck in Brazil than they would in the U.S. So their few cents, what they will make an impact with in America, they go down to these countries, and they try to impress with these women. But everybody's not the same. After a while, your few dollars could only go so far.
Oh my gosh, the women are now unimpressed. But you know something? Because you have such disdain
for your women that you believe that by doing this, you'll make them feel even more unworthy.
That is to those women who actually acknowledge you, who give you the time of day. You know, you guys, these men need to work on themselves, travel. Traveling expands your horizons. And it really helps you to shape, you know, it helps to shape one's perspective. I have found that American women are more receptive to new information than the American black men. Especially those career women who they label as hard to get along with. Oh, really? Because you have your expectations, you're hard to get along with. No, they are just intentional because you cannot put in the work necessary for your progression as a human being, as a person, to be the best version of who you are, and then settle for someone whose mindset is just stuck.
Mind you, it is stuck in the non-progressive. Now listen, I've traveled quite a bit. Whether it was for my business, my job, that was when I was employed with those people.
Whether it is personal, it is always refreshing. Every time I'm allowed to experience something or someone outside of my regular interactions. Always. I mean, by now, if you've watched my other videos, you'd be aware that I'm adventurous and a true bred risk taker. I welcome new perspectives. That's me. So I've said all of that to say that my encounters with black American men, because I travel to the US quite often, have been minimal on purpose. Because I found that they can be very condescending and uninteresting. And if you're not able to hold my interest, well then what are we talking about? I find a man who complains about his circumstances without putting in the effort to effect change is dull and will be unable to stimulate me intellectually or otherwise.
Yes, catch that. On the other hand, my other encounters and interactions have been quite pleasant and enlightening. Passport bros and their delusions have finally
led to their undoing.
Oh my gosh, my, how the tables have turned. They are now the undesirables. Anyway, please check my other videos. Give them a thumbs up, down, whatever. Just interact. Please engage. And as always, stay safe and be self-aware. And subscribe for more tidbits of wisdom and real talk. See you in the next video.